Hi, this is Mark Vett with a quick look at the new Dynamics AX. The subject for today is workflow. I work for a company called Sikich, which is headquartered near Chicago. It's a professional services firm, been in business for over 30 years and have over 700 employees located in 11 regional offices around the country. Sikich is known as a good place to work. It is also a great regional accounting firm, but perhaps most important for companies that are looking at enterprise software. We are a Microsoft partner, and we are in the top 1% of all technology solution providers in the world, certified member of the President's Club and the Inner Circle with Microsoft. Some of the challenges that companies face that can be solved with a good workflow tool include control. There are certain types of records in an ERP system that can be created by users based upon their permissions and their role. But sometimes there's a little additional control that the company wants to create upon those records and how they're created and what process they have to go through. Another challenge is consistency. Can we apply that type of control consistently from one entry to another so that people know what to expect when they're working within the enterprise system? And finally, there can be various paths for records to follow based upon some limits. You know, perhaps it's a spending limit, you know, up to $500, the user can submit the record without any review. Over 500 and under 5,000, perhaps it's reviewed by their manager. Over 5,000, it goes to the controller, things like that. To see how the workflow tool solves some of these challenges, let's jump into the new Dynamics AX. There are a couple of prerequisites in AX to enabling workflow. Since we're going to be looking at a purchase order workflow process today, I would have to go to my procurement and sourcing menu and select my procurement and sourcing parameters and make sure that I had change management checked. That will allow me to enable workflow and to control changes to purchase orders through that. The next thing I'm going to do is go to my procurement sourcing workflow option under the setup menu. And this is where I define the workflows that apply to purchase requisitions. Let's select this last one here called the purchase order workflow and open it within the workflow tool. This is going to prompt me for my credentials to log in to the workflow editor in the cloud. After I have provided those credentials, it will open up this workflow window to give me a graphic representation of the workflow that I'm looking at. And you'll notice that in this case, it's a very simple workflow. Start, one conditional approval step, and then end, which means that basically it's going to be submitted for an approval. It'll go through one conditional approval process, and then it will complete and return to the originator of the workflow to allow them to continue with their process. The settings on the workflow are way beyond the scope of this presentation today. I just want to point out a couple of things. Notice that when you're looking at the workflow as a whole, you have some activation and some notification settings that you can do. As I begin to drill into other parts of the workflow, I have some automatic actions that can be defined. In other words, I could have some automatic approval happen based upon some kind of criteria. And as I drill in one more level to the actual conditionals on this step, I can define the assignment and escalation if I want this to be escalated to other users if the original approver didn't get to it. And I can also define the conditions upon which this kind of approval has to happen. In this case, I want to focus on just the one, the assignment. Notice that my assignment has a lot of flexibility built into it. If I had a company hierarchy defined that define subordinates and managers, etc., this would allow me to enforce that at the workflow. So that regardless of who the user was that submitted a purchase order for approval, it would go to that person's manager reading that from the company hierarchy. For the purpose of our demo, I've defined a specific user, and that user is Inga. So when I submit my purchase order for approval, it's going to be routed to Inga for her review. That's just a quick overview of the graphical workflow editor. I'm going to cancel out of this form to come back to my list of workflows that are defined. We can see that there is this purchase order workflow we just looked at. It is active and it is our default. So the next step in our process is to actually create a purchase order and walk through this approval process to see how it works. To do so, I'm going to return to my homepage and I will click on my workspace for purchase order preparation. I'm going to create a new purchase order. I'll walk through the header setup quickly so we can get to the point of entering some line detail and submitting our purchase order for approval. Now that I have the purchase order header defined and I'm into the line detail, a couple of things will be apparent. First of all, the status of the purchase order in the top right now says draft. That is something new. You didn't see that until a workflow was applied to this particular process. The next thing you'll notice is that I don't have the ability to run a confirmation and send a copy of the purchase order to my vendor because I now have a workflow involved. And so now it has added a workflow button up here at the top. Let's quickly add some line detail. Now that I have some line detail in place, I'm going to have to submit this to workflow because I can't confirm the order and send it to the vendor. So I'm going to go to workflow and I'm going to click on submit. And I can add a comment here, finish my submit process, and you'll notice that now the status of the purchase order is in review, which means that, again, I can't confirm it yet because it's in the review process and it's waiting for the approver, defined by that workflow, to review and accept or reject the PO. To go to that next step and see what the approver is going to see from this process, I'm going to log in as another user. Give me a moment to do that. I'm going to start a new session, and I'm going to log in as Inga. Now I'm into a new session, logged in as the user Inga, as it says up here in the top right-hand corner. You can see that Inga has a different dashboard. She has access to only certain parts of AX. But one of the things that she will see when she opens up is that under her list of work items assigned is now a PO approval submit. When she clicks on that link, it will take her to the workflow step of reviewing the purchase order and either accepting or rejecting that. She could drill further if she'd like to review the line details of this purchase order and the total amount on it. If she's happy with what she sees here, and she goes to the workflow icon, and she has the ability to either approve, reject, she could request a change, she could delegate this to another user. In this case, she's going to answer approve. She could add a comment, and then finish her approve step, and that goes away. When Inga goes back to her home page, she no longer has that message from the workflow that she has to respond to. Now let's log out as Inga, and we'll log back in again to review our purchase order. Now I'm back to my screen as the original user that submitted this purchase order, and you'll notice that it still shows as in review. Let me hit a refresh on this page to see if it will update. Sure enough, Inga has accepted or approved my purchase order, and it now updates within AX to show that it's approved. You'll also notice that now I have a confirmation process available to me. I can confirm this purchase order, and using print management could send this to my vendor so it can be accepted and processed. To summarize, the workflow utility inside of the new Dynamics AX gives companies the ability to define a process that is consistent and repeatable, to enforce that process with the system, preventing users from actually confirming or submitting a process to be completed until after that review has happened. And finally, it gives you the ability to define conditional flows based upon the value of the record, based upon the unit or the manager of that group, and complete flexibility to define that process. If you have any questions about Sikich or about the workflow process, feel free to email me at the email below. Thank you and have a great day.